temple foretold. When some were speaking about the temple, how it was adorned with beautiful stones and gifts dedicated to God, he said, "As for these things that you see, the days will come when not one stone will be left upon another. All will be thrown down." They asked him, "Teacher, when will this be? And what will be the sign that this is about to take place?" And he said, "Beware that you are not led astray. For many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and 'the time is near.' Do not go after them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified. For these things must take place first, but the end will not follow immediately." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places famines and plagues. And there will be dreadful portents and great signs from heaven. But before all this occurs, they will arrest you and persecute you. They will hand you over to synagogues and prisons, and you will be brought before kings and governors because of my name. This will give you an opportunity to testify. So make up your minds not to prepare your defense in advance. For I will give you words and a wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be betrayed, even by parents and brothers, by relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your souls."
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the 90s, I was questioned by a non-Catholic office mate of mine, "Why do we adore Jesus as God, where in fact they only treat him as a prophet?" You know what? I was caught off guard. I became speechless. I failed to defend my belief, my faith. That's why from that time onwards, I told myself, I'll study scripture well, and at any given chance, I could defend my faith. Then I became a member of Couples for Christ, and I became more emboldened to put up a defense. But mind you, I didn't want to show off or just go into any debate for that matter, but just to correct notions thought about Catholicism. That's why, in the earlier days of me being a member of CFC, my wife and I wanted to become full-time missionaries, but fate had it otherwise. Instead, both my wife and I became extraordinary ministers of the Holy Communion. Nowadays, after hearing talks on apologetics, we also wanted to be apologists as well. But I've learned that it takes a lot of studies about theology, about Marian studies, to be one. One famous theologian said, "Do not be confrontational. Just correct your brother who has an unfounded opinion about Catholicism, about Jesus, Mother Mary, and the saints. Do it in a loving and concerned way." He said, "It will come. People will ask questions, and that's the opportune time to give them an explanation." When people question you, that means to say they're ready to listen. Study and pray for guidance by the Holy Spirit when the opportunity knocks. So now I invite you to pray with me. Lord, please give us the grace to know and hear your voice. May we follow you now and always, and may we never be deceived by many false prophets. Jesus, we trust in you. Amen. Good morning, everybody. It's a Sunday, the 13th of November in the year of our Lord 2022. Don't forget to go to Mass. Please like and share this YouTube video of mine, as others might need a prayer or to hear the Holy Gospel. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe so that you will be updated for more of these videos. Okay, thank you very much in advance. You all keep safe and God bless.